Jack Rooke, yes. Welcome along. I love your curly hair.
Oh, thank you so
much. I'm very much in favour of it.
I spent a childhood being compared to you, actually.
Did you really?
Yeah.
So sorry.
You and Sideshow Bob. I much preferred... You look like a young, chubby Jonathan Creek. That was always when I sort of took more confidence from.
Well, I hope that was of some support.
Yeah, we're both sort of kind of working in the realms of crime.
Yeah, well, Sideshow Bob, very much.
Very much so.
In the thick of crime.
I do remember being, like, hurled that. In 2018, during the World Cup, I was wearing, like, a sort of pink mac and basically, like, really straight. I just looked like an absolute twat. I looked like I was sort of, you know, deserving of being bullied. And everyone went, Sideshow Bob, Sideshow Bob. And one guy at the end was like, oh, Jonathan Creek. And I thought, I'd rather the latter.
Could be Jonathan Creek. And you, what's the problem with tech and you?
My problem with tech, I mean, this is, we're starting off with quite a dark story.
Okay. So
a couple of months ago, I had a phone call from a family member of mine, and it was a bit of a shocking phone call. I just had what is known for sakes, I should say, I'm what's known in show business as a homosexual. And I had something called a Grindr hookup with a lovely gentleman who didn't quite know when to leave the next
day. Was he a gentleman, really, though?
He was. Sadly, he was. He was, yeah, too much of a gentleman. And
we won't go into what that means.
We're all thinking about it, though, aren't we? Yeah.
Sounds fun.
He was a cracking day. The next morning, I got this phone call whilst he was with me, and I was sort of thinking, oh, God, I really need him to leave. But I sort of looked at this phone call, and this phone call, and this is where it gets dark, was from my sister-in-law, who had sadly passed away 2 years before the phone call. So I'm sort of stuck between Grindr hookup that won't leave and dead sister-in-law ringing my phone. And I sort of go into a bit of panic, being like, how? I was thinking maybe she's had her phone robbed, maybe it's been the number's been reassigned. And he was like, well, answer it. And I was like, she's dead. I'm not answering this call. And anyway, I let the call ring and then I called my mum. And I was like, Mum, I've just had a phone call and I could hear that my mum was laughing in the background of the call. And then I could also hear that my niece was there. And so I clicked on FaceTime and they could tell immediately they were drunk. And I was like, how you're drunk at midday on a Sunday.
I mean, let's not judge.
Let's not judge.
I've been there.
And I was like, how has this happened? And she went, well, me and Charlotte, we've been on the Quantros. And I was like, great. And we tried to call you, but we tried to call you off the Amazon Alexa. And we said, Alexa, call Jack. And it turned out that Christmas, before my sister-in-law had passed, she had got my mum an Amazon Alexa and registered it to her mobile phone number, which meant for the year since, my mum had been calling people off the Amazon Alexa and it had been coming up with my dead sister-in-law's number. And what the worst part of this is that for a whole year, nobody had flagged this to my mum. And people had thought my mum was just skimping on her phone bill by using my sister-in-law's phone. Really, I mean, like, quite dark. And still, to this day, I do not know if it's been changed or if there is a way of lobbying Amazon to change it.
Yeah, that is
my question, Jack.
Yeah.
Why don't you trust tech? That, to me, I mean, it's not great.
Yeah.
But tech is very... I'm a tech guy. I do quite enjoy tech. I think you should put a bit more trust in tech.
The not trusting tech was actually the Grindr part of the affair. On Grindr. There is no... Yeah, the whole dead sister-in-law phone bill was a huge risk to get to that. There is no... They don't tell you on Grindr etiquette, you know, somebody might stay once Sunday brunch has finished. No. When Tim Lovejoy and Simon Rimmer are on, that's your time to go. But no, I don't trust.
I've been saying it for years.
I just think how a dead woman can call you beyond the grave. I was like sort of shaking because I was really. I was mostly worried that all my sort of bitchy texts that I'd sent about my brother to my sister-in-law over the years had been compromised. Alas, no, my mum had just been calling people. And it had been coming out with my sister-in-law's number. But actually, I thought it was quite beautiful because it's exactly the sort of thing my sister-in-law would have loved for her legacy to be, that my mum is calling people and her name is flashing up on people's phones.
Did it cross your mind that it would be something from the other side, something unexplained?
Genuinely, for a split second, I was like, does she need something? And I thought, no, she's been dead 2 years.
Did you say this to your Grindr date?
Well, eventually I had to, and that cleared him off.
If you enjoyed that, remember to subscribe to Dave and click the notification bell so you don't miss any of our fresh content. Let us know in the comments who you'd like to see join me around the table, and head over to UKTV Play, where you can stream old episodes of As Yet Untitled for free.